sea urchin, uni, tuyom, whatever name you want to call it, it is one of our water's most treasured prizes. It's sweet, salty, creamy, and rich, so it's easy to see why people who love food cannot resist the call of sea urchin. Here in Camiguin, you don't have tuyom in a restaurant. You have it fresh from the sea. Local fisherman Dodong is kind enough to let me join him as he harvests tuyom. Look, as delicious as sea urchin may be, its spikes can be nasty. Plus, there is the not-so-small matter of not all species being edible. You do need a local expert on this matter. Several tosses in the basket will help get rid of the painful spiky tips. And then, they're ready to be enjoyed.
Okay, so I get to enjoy the fruits of my labor. And a while ago, I was talking about tuyom, the sea urchin, and Dodong was explaining to me that there are actually two kinds here. The tuyom is the Japanese kind, the one we call uni, and then this is called swaki, right? Swaki. So this is a local version, and it actually has less spikes. It's pretty short, so it's you can actually grab it by your hand, which we did a while ago. And so I think it has a distinct taste. Different from uni. Let's find out. Okay. This one is actually a lot saltier than your normal uni. And but it's still nice and creamy. Beautiful taste. So this is a local spiced vinegar. And some of them add this vinegar because this is a little bit more salty than the normal uni, and the vinegar should play a really great partner. Yeah, nice and spicy, the vinegar. Beautiful. Worth all the trouble. Well, actually worth all his trouble. I was just hanging around.
And the tuyom, creamy and rich and oh so sweet. We've tried it at restaurants before, but as with most seafood, nothing beats the flavor of sea urchin when it's fresh right out from the sea. How fresh, you ask? Well, it's still alive. Here's the best part. 3 pieces cost only 50 pesos here. You bet I'm taking these home with me.
Now, whenever I get sea urchin, the first urge is, of course, to just eat it straight, fresh. But I also have this go-to recipe that I like to use when I have leftover uni, and that's uni noodles. But this time, you know, the sea urchin here is not uni, but swaki. So it's a little bit saltier than your normal uni. So I want to enhance that freshness with a little bit of sweetness from our vegetables. So I'm going to start with some carrots. And we're just going to slice these julienne. Of course, that's just a fancy name for slicing things thinly. I have here dried shiitake mushrooms. And I love using dried in this recipe because you have to rehydrate the mushrooms anyway. And then you get this beautiful liquid right here. And that's going to be the base of our stock. I love using shiitake mushrooms. They have this really great umami flavor, and it actually enhances the umami flavor from the uni. So what you get is this really luxurious, flavorful dish. And I don't want to use onions because the onion flavor is a little bit too strong. It might mask the sea urchin flavor. So I'm just going to use the white parts of the green onion. And then I'm going to use the green parts for garnish. So the first thing you have to do actually is get a pot of boiling water ready, because as with noodles or pasta or anything, the noodles never wait for anybody. So you have to make sure that the sauce is ready before you cook the noodles. There you go. So these guys are fresh ingredients, so I want to start with cooking them first, and then I'm going to drop in the mushrooms later. I don't want to add too much salt because, like I said, the swaki is a little bit salty, the sea urchin. So just a touch, then some black pepper. Nice. Okay, one more toss. Nice. Okay, the vegetables are beginning to get a little bit softer. That's when we add in our mushrooms. If you're using a really sweet sea urchin, then you want to use maybe a sake or a rice wine. But I need a little bit of that sweetness. I'm going to add mirin. I'm going to let that reduce a little bit. Now, a little bit of water. Just a little bit, because then I'm going to add in that mushroom water. So I rehydrated the dried shiitakes and you get this lovely dark water. And that's going to have all the flavors of the mushrooms, right? When you dry the shiitakes, like the mushroom flavor just gets really powerful, really nice. Okay, so I've got here some fresh miki noodles. They call them miki noodles, but you know, I can use them for pancit canton as well. And these are freshly made, so they won't take long to cook. Maybe about 3-4 minutes tops. The vegetables are really super sweet, so I actually didn't need to use the mirin like I thought I did. So I need to add a little bit more salt just to balance it out. Okay, noodles are ready, veggies are ready. All I'm gonna do now is combine both. A little bit of cream, and then finish it off with some sea urchin. Then we can eat!
Lastly, the icing on the cake. I must say, helping Dodong harvest the swake enhanced my enjoyment of this dish. Living like a local has its perks, and I am loving them.